everyone, welcome to Cahuilla Creek Motocross Park. Pat Foster and I are here today giving the 2023 GasGas MC450 a little run through. So thanks to our friends at O'Neill Racing that made this all possible. For 2023, the GasGas is completely unchanged, save for a set of new graphics, the little super edgy split down the middle of the GasGas wording is the only difference we have for 2023. When the KTM group launched or acquired GasGas, it was designed to be the more affordable bike. It was the same the first year, save for the buttons and stuff, because that was what they had to start with, right? But the factory edition Husky and KTM last year led into the new chassis, new bike this year for the KTM and Husky. Well, guess what? The GasGas is the same, but that is not a bad thing because it's a good bike. I mean, what do you think? Some guy just came up to me today and was like, hey, so really, what do you think? And I go, it's a good bike. It's a great bike. It doesn't do anything bad for me. It does everything very well. It's not like the most exciting or not the best anything, but it's very good.
You know, I think for a lot of people, this is the best bike for them. This is the best choice because one of the things that they did with the new bike, the new KTM and new Husky, is they made a more rigid frame, stiffer frame. Both bikes are a little bit more aggressive in power, where this bike, it's got, I'd say everything's just a little bit smoother, a little bit softer. You could definitely feel more frame flex in this bike, right? So it's a little more compliant. And then it's got a pretty mellow suspension setting, so it's pretty plush.
Yeah.
A little light for me, maybe even a little light for you. But for a lot of folks, I think it's a really good balance, right? To be honest, I wasn't that excited about riding this bike today because I kind of remembered the power being like smoother and mellower. I was actually pretty surprised at how much grunt it had. Like this thing barks really good.
Yeah, it's very easy to ride and stay in control on because it doesn't go, brah! Yep. It's a very linear power band, easy to ride. I've been trying to ride with less clutch because people bag on me on my vlogs. So I'm like, okay, ride, put your fingers on the grips. Well, you know what? That bike's really easy to do it on because it's such a broad, easy to control power band.
I like it because it does have a lot of torque down low, right? So it's very usable. You can carry a higher gear, and just like what you're working on, trying to carry a higher gear, smooth with the power, no clutch, it's pretty good for that, right? It lends itself to that type of riding style.
Yeah.
But I think it's also got some pretty good torque. Pretty good rev to it.
Yeah.
I mean, rev's pretty high, and it goes well.
Yeah, it's funny because getting on this bike, by the way, we have Storm Watch 2022 right now. The weather app said storms at 1 p.m., flash flood warning. We were driving in this morning, blue skies are all, they're full of shit.
Yeah.
A lot. Wow.
Clear skies, it's like 100.
Yeah. But, okay, so the bike.
Yeah.
In our shootout, right?
Yeah.
In the shootout last year, I tried to ride all the Austrian bikes in a row. Because they have a distinctly different feel than a Japanese bike. So, boom, boom, boom. I remember getting on the gas, guessing, going, whoa, this thing is noodly and it's soft and slow. But that's only when you get right off of a brand new Husky or KTM, right?
Yeah.
I got on this thing today and I had a big smile on my face. It was super easy to ride. Very predictable, very comfortable. I think if I was going to take this bike home and race it this year, I would get the map button from KTM guys so I could access map 2.
Yep.
And stiffen the suspension up and maybe not even a whole exhaust, just the back half.
Sure, sure. You know, I'm a pretty big fan of the new KTM. I like it. All the things they did to make that bike more aggressive, I like. The stiffer frame's good for me. The stiffer suspension's good. More power's good. So that's why I say, and I wasn't that thrilled to ride this bike. And just like you said, hey, if you just show up and ride this bike, like if this is the only bike you're riding, man, I had a ball on this thing today. Yeah. The track's kind of soft and loose, which lends itself to the softer suspension settings, the little milder frame, all of those things just worked really well for me today. Plus, I thought the motor felt great, right? And this big triple step up in the bottom, like I just revved that thing out in second. It kept revving. It wasn't a problem. I thought it was gonna go flat, but it would pull it.
Yeah.
And I don't know, I had a lot more fun today than I thought I was gonna have. So to reply to you, if I was gonna race this bike, I'd absolutely need to make the suspension stiffer. If it's an option, buy that map switch. Mm-hmm. So you have map two and ride this thing.
Yeah.
It's really good.
One thing about the setup, when we first got on it, we went recommended sag, just like 104, 105.
Yep.
I felt like I was, I don't want to say stink buggy per se, like a Honda, but I felt like I was under braking because the stuff's softer, it dove a little more. Like I couldn't get behind the bike, right?
Yep.
So I came in, took some preload off the shock and set my shock sag at 108 and loved it.
Yep.
I did that because at our shootout last week, that's where I ended up, right?
Sure.
I ended up at 108 on the gas, 108 on the Husky. No, 108 on the KTM, but on the Husky I went 106 because it was already low low.
Right.
But yeah, did you like the lower sag or did you?
You know, I did, and then the forks were a little bit too soft for me. So we did two different things, right? You came in and lowered the shock. I came in and put more air in the fork, right? I just needed the fork to be a little bit stiffer. So I put a little more air in the fork and then softened the compression a little bit to compensate for that. But we were both going for the same thing. A little more height in the front end. It's got a little front end bias.
Yeah.
Right? So take that front end bias away and the bike just seems to track a little better. And I think it corners better. That's unusual, right? Usually you want a little more weight on the front. This thing corners better, closer to balance, I think.
Yeah. So, I mean, I don't know what else there is to say. The 2023 Gas MC450. It's a great bike.
It's
more affordable than the others. I think it looks good. I like that red color. Matches the little red hits on my O'Neill gear. I would have to put black wheels on it though if I kept it full time.
Yep.
Silver wheels are like, I don't know, they're kind of out.
It looks a little dated.
Yeah.
It looks a little dated. The rest of the bike looks great. Yeah. I love this red.
I have to say, Max's tires.
Oh, you know what?
Comfortable.
I was going to mention that to you. They felt really good out here today, right? The dirt's really loose. It's pretty soft. That tire's really good.
Yeah, especially the rear. The ST rear, big fan of that thing.
Yep.
Just can't go to a hard pack track because it rips the knobs off.
Right.
Yeah.
Right. No, it's a performance tire, right? It's there to race. It doesn't last as long, but it's good while you have it.
Yeah. So anyhow, guys, there you have it. We're going to continue to put time on this. Our goal this year for our 450 shootout is to have at least 10 hours on all the bikes to break the frames in, because as we know in the past, we've showed up with a brand new Husky and it's like super rigid and stiff. So we're gonna put the time in, find out more stuff about this bike. We'll post update videos. So stay tuned to swapmotolive.com for more. Thank you for watching.